Hello, everybody. It's 8:31 a.m. Central Time on the 29th of November, 2022. It is Tuesday here in the United States, and I hope you are doing well. We are here on the Earthquake 3D live stream, and I'm recording because I've got some breaking news for everybody you may not have heard about on the news, or if you did, it may have just been a blurb. You need to see. Let me go ahead and turn on the screen here so that you get a display capture. Here we are 6 hours ago, people in Hawaii posting shots of the new fissures which formed on the side of the flank of Mauna Loa and are flowing out excessively large. And now this isn't end of the world. This is not crazy, but it is a lot of lava coming out. Here's a live view. This is from Two Pineapple Stream, which I'm going to put a link down below in this video when I upload it to YouTube for you guys to go over to their channel and subscribe up there. Again, we're relying on citizen journalists to bring this to us because we're getting shaky hand cam videos from helicopter cockpits from the pros hours old. They're not streaming it live. We also have another channel that's doing it, another channel that's streaming live showing us from a distance. And this is, again, live. Let me hit play on this really quick. We can just move our mouse forward. You guys can see that it's, again, it's a live view. It's just from a distance, so the smoke kind of looks like it's standing still. But it is moving. So this is a lot. Now, they have a 45,000-foot-high ash advisory accompanying this, which is just mind-blowing to me to even see on the list. But yet it is. Also, Alaska erupting up to the north at Pavlov Volcano. But we're here to talk about Mauna Loa and the 45,000 foot FL450 observed volcanic ash cloud coming off of this new fissure, series of fissures that has formed. I'm going to take you over to my Twitter page and we'll show you the tweets which I've been making, which again show this and this and this. But here's our shaky helicopter flyover. Let me turn down the volume so you don't get blown away. And I called this 2 days ago. I issued a forecast that the professionals would fly over in a helicopter and have a shaky hand cam out the window of the cockpit and have excessively loud chopper sound in there on purpose to make it unpalatable to watch. And how could I have known, right? So this is just sad because, again, take a look at it. They're getting, they got more of the window frame in there than what we need to see with the lava flow. Shaky hand cam out the cockpit, right? Showing us where these new fissures have formed, which are now really large fissures, which are going to be reaching out additional mileage on the lava flows. So now let's get an idea of the spot that's breaking apart, and then we can kind of calculate how far the lava flows might go. Now, we would think that they would reach the ocean if it's a tremendous amount of lava flowing out. And we'll jump back over just really quick and go look at the live stream one more time from Two Pineapples. So here we go, Two Pineapples showing us the live view. Look at the fountains of lava coming out of the new fissures. So the new fissures are on the side of the volcano. The lava flow is reaching out at least a couple miles at this point. Where did the fissures form? Well, let's go back and show you. I marked, according to the USGS map, exactly where the Mauna Loa Observatory is and where Red Hill Cabin is, which is right here. There's Red Hill Cabin. And a straight line between them I drew, of course, going by the USGS map. And the new fissures they have just out in front of it, somewhere right in here, where there are previous fissure points, previous break butte points, spatter cone points, and so forth, on the side of the volcano. So the flow is on right here where I have this yellow place mark, new fissures, and you can see which way the flow would most likely go. Now, if it's just ever so slightly east, it'll go down and go this way. And if it's ever so slightly west or right where it's at now, it'll go this way. Now, the length of the lava flows in the past when a fissure happens, I measured, and we'll do that again right now. For instance, this fissure on the side reached all the way down to the ocean here. It actually went 30 miles linear. That was a fissure a long time ago, and it was pretty far down the flank of the volcano. Now, really, the way you have to look at it is on the side that everything above the fissure which just formed, see where it says new fissures, November 28th, everything above that is going to drain out. So the whole top of the volcano already erupted, flowed out, but then the magma is going to go down, 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 even with this. Now, same time, the chamber from down below is going to keep recharging. So it will keep coming out and flow down as long as it does. Now, we have past examples to show how long this goes for. So all the other previous flows I measured go up to 30 miles, and most are 18. 17, 16, 18 miles. We have 11 miles down to the bend, and then some of them flow out enough that it's another additional, you know, 7 or 8 miles, and that puts us to 18 miles down the slope and over to the west. All these past examples of fissures breaking out. See, we have 7 or 8 miles, and then super huge long ones going out, 17 or 18 miles in the past. And the younger black-colored flows from the 1980s and 1970s eruptions, and going back even further, all about the same distance. So if this holds true, that the amount of magma that flows out from on the top, or going from the top down to where it breaks, usually equals about 18 miles. We have a couple examples of ones going further that reach all the way down almost to the ocean, if not directly to the ocean. You see that, right? Now, there's a landfill here, a sanitary landfill. Also, sanitary landfill right next to the Hilton golf course. There's also another golf course out in there. Now, if this lava flow comes all that way, I'll be surprised if it gets all the way down to the ocean. But again, when you see the size of this, let's go back live. The size of the fountains now and the size of the fissures, we have at least 1, 2, and 3. And that is a live view from Two Pineapples over in Hawaii. The fact that we have to rely on citizen journalists somewhat troubles me. I appreciate them doing this, citizen journalists and the citizen scientists who are documenting this for us, while the professionals are literally omitting all of this. Now, I need to take everybody back in time just a little bit, about 6 months, maybe a year ago at the most, right here, out in the ocean, out here off the coast of Africa. There was a big eruption at a small volcano called La Palma in the Canary Islands. And mainstream media, as well as citizens, had live streams going the whole time for 3 months, showing us every bit in detail, almost, of the lava flows coming out of this small volcano there out in the middle of the ocean in the Atlantic. Now, I'm 100% positive we have high-speed internet connection with cables that go from Hawaii over here to mainland U.S. And that I'm 100% positive, too, that there's millions of people in Hawaii right now for the holiday season and just for wintertime in general. And we only have a handful of citizens that are covering this. No mainstream coverage. There's some weird reason why they're not showing us the live lava flows. And I would think that they don't want to cause panic with the tourists. They don't have enough boats. They don't have enough planes to get all the people out of there if they started showing this stuff. I'm not saying it's going to go affect anybody. I'm just saying people will leave in mass when they see it because of that, just the way it looks. They're like, oh, shit, I'm getting out of here. And they don't, you know, there's no reason to. Maybe, you know, again, you might be, if you're up close to the lava or something, or it's coming towards that golf course at the Hilton place, then you might need to get out of there. But otherwise, it's just a spectacular thing to see. But tourists don't understand that. They see the glowing red off in the distance, and they think the whole island's going to explode. And so they leave. And they don't have enough airplanes or boats to get everybody out of there at once. And they also don't want to lose their asses because this thing could stop in a few days. It could. It could stop in a few days, or it could go on for weeks or months. They're hoping it would stop in days. And Joe Schmo tourist still comes out for the winter and still comes for their Christmas plans and everything like that for New Year's. And don't want to be worrying about this. So don't show it live. That's kind of where we're at. And that's the real deal, guys. I'm not joking. That's why we don't have an awesome live stream coming from the USGS. It's shameful, I know. Yes, it's scandalous, But this is the way the world really works. It's the same reason we don't get many earthquakes reported off the coast of Oregon and Washington State, because of what happened with the undersea eruption out there with the axial seamount back in 2015. General public, Joe Schmo, once they see glowing red anything on screen, they go crazy. You literally have to tell people, guys, don't worry. And then they call you a shill. So here's me. Guys, don't worry. Even if a fissure breaks out on the side, looks like it's still going to go down to the ocean and not affect anybody. Everybody else, Dutch, somebody got to you. Government got to you. I'm like, dude, shut the fuck up. And yes, a fissure broke out on the side. And yes, it's going to flow down to the ocean. Still not end of the world. It's a big deal, but it's nothing crazy. It's something that I should cover, and a few other channels who cover geophysics should cover, and the professionals should cover. And the mainstream media, they should all have just stuff on it, showing it all. And happens about every 40 or 50 years, and there it is. Let's watch it flow. To do all this mystery shit with it, hide the streams and make sure that nobody sees it, that's what makes me think something weird is going on. Like, what do they know that I don't know? Is this whole thing going to break out and it's going to flow out everywhere? Everybody going to die? Like, here's me out going out on a limb saying it's not going to do anything much. It's just going to flow out to the ocean. And they're all like, no, Dutch, don't say that, because everyone's going to be dead here in a few days. I mean, I just don't think that. I don't believe that. I don't think that's going to happen. So why are they hiding it? The only thing I can think of is money, man. Money. Tourist bucks. Because tourist freak. Anyway, I'm no Sherlock. I don't know why they're doing it. All I know is that we have citizens that are doing this in place of professionals. All right. Much love, guys.